Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at GeekTool. So GeekTool is an interesting way for you to extend your desktop by adding little widgets to it. Things that you can see on your desktop that are kind of there in the background. So you can get GeekTool in the Mac App Store. Just do a quick search for it and it'll come right up and you could download it for free. So here's what GeekTool looks like when you run it. Now you drag and drop things out of here onto your desktop. So for instance, let's try dragging an image out. It's going to create this little space here on the desktop that I can move around anywhere I want. And then under properties here, I can set properties of that image. Now that image can be something locally, like a local image that you've got, but that doesn't really give it any functionality. What's more interesting is to put a URL. I'm going to paste in the URL of a satellite image that's updated from the US government. And now what will happen is I can put it here and I can drag it and enlarge it. And that image is on the desktop. If I click out of GeekTool and I'm just in the Finder now, I can see that it's just there on the background. It's part of the background of the desktop. It will remain there. I can cover it with stuff. I can't drag it or anything until I select GeekTool again and then I can drag it. But the cool thing is that will update as the image changes. So every day I can look and see the new weather information. Weather is an obvious one, but you can think of probably other images that are out there where there's a static URL but the actual image that's there changes, like say maybe a webcam or something. In addition, you can drag file information here. So this will put some text here on the desktop, and this text I can put anywhere I want and I can resize the window and I can set what it is. So like I can, for instance, use a log file here. Like let me get my Apache firewall log if I want to be really geeky, and it will put that information there on the desktop, and as that file changes it will be updated. So this could be something here where you can have logs or some other information that appears and it changes. And again, if I am not in GeekTool, you can see it's just static information on the desktop. It's not really static, it will be updated, but I can't change it or affect it. It's really there on the desktop in the background. Now probably the most ultra geeky thing that you could do is to use a shell script. Let me put a shell script here, and a shell script is kind of like, it's like a terminal command. And I can do something like top, which will display information about things that are running on my Mac, and I can have it update every 3 seconds, say. Let me make it an easier color to see. There we go. So now you can see this information here. You can see the results of top, or I could use something like well, all sorts of different things to display the current date. You can see it displays the date there as it would return from a terminal command, but in addition I can now customize that by changing the font and color. So I can put a clock on my desktop that easily, like that. And now if I click off, you can see that just stays there on the background on the desktop. And remember I said it's update every 3 seconds, so you can see it's doing that. It probably, for this one, I want to set it to update every second. So it now acts like a normal clock there on the background of my desktop. And you can use any shell script. So the more you know about programming, the more you know about terminal commands, you can put different bits on here, geeklets they're called, on your desktop to give you information. And then when you quit GeekTool, you can say, no, I do not want to disable GeekTool. I just want to quit the running app there. And I'm not running the app anymore, but this information remains on the screen. You can see this is updating. This would update if that Apache firewall log would update. And also this weather image here would update all at the same time while things change in the world. So that's the basics. Now if you search for GeekTool ideas or GeekTool geeklets or whatever on the internet, you'll find out all sorts of ideas that other people have done with GeekTool. Stuff that they can use from shell scripts and images and text files or URLs that they can display on their desktop to give them useful information and make them more productive. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.